if we have any vandalized road signs, any faded pavement markings, any cracks or potholes on the pavement, or anything related, of course, to the road network. So I'm trying to check how I can classify these assets in order to, and the defects of these assets in order to help him check this very quickly in order to save some time, let's say. So let's go to the reality. To the reality, of course, we have some problems on the roads, potholes, cracks, as you know. But it's not only about the pavement, it's also about issues on the rest of the road network, like, for example, drainage issues or faded road markings or debris on the road. We also might have some vandalized road signs or barriers or even bridges that have settled in. So when in the year 1516, the road expenditures were for the UK were 9 billion. From these 9 billion, almost half of them were giving for the maintenance. From this maintenance, 20% was giving for the routine maintenance and the planning and strategy, which is again a very large number. And so I'm trying, it's very costly, but it's not only that the routine maintenance is very costly, but it's also not happening very frequently. For example, the highways, it happens only one or twice per year, and for the minor roads, even less, like one per 2 years. So there are some techniques, as I told you before, like computer vision techniques and machine learning techniques, that what they're trying to do is first to capture the geometry of these assets, because most of the road assets have the same geometry, thankfully. And the second that they're trying to do is to capture the condition, if they have any defects. For example, as we can see here, the road lanes, for example, have similar structure, similar geometry, sorry. There are the potholes that also might have similar geometry, so it's very easy to be captured. So, and also from here, for example, we can see that the light poles have also similar geometries, which makes our work very, very helpful. So what I did is, since the geometry more or less and the defects are might be similar for most of the road assets, what we did is that we took manuals from four different areas of the world. Of course, we prefer the English manuals. And we tried to check, for example, from the UK manuals, which were the main categories of the road assets. So for the UK manuals, we have the road, which they describe it as pavement and markings and drainage. So everything, vegetation, everything is more or less is inside the road category. We have, for example, the lights and the light poles, the structures like bridges or tunnels, and the footpaths and cycle routes like pedestrian roads, for example, are also in a separate category. The Hong Kong manuals, and they have also similar categories like the UK. They have the roads, for example, as a similar category, the street lighting as another similar category. But what makes a difference is that they don't have structures, they have slopes, and they put too much emphasis in the landscape and the environment. So they have a different category. For the Australia, they have, again, similar structure like the UK one. They have, of course, the roads and the structures. They have a different category for the intersections, a different category for the environment and corridors, and they have a new category, the ITS elements, which means the intelligent transport system elements like loop detectors or something like that. So, and the California one, which again has the ITC elements on the road assets category, they have the pavement, of course, but they have the culverts in another category and the bridges, not the structures, in a different one. So if you combine all of this, we were trying to see how we can check which assets have similar geometry and which assets have similar defects. Because actually my road inspector, what he wants or she wants to see is the defects of these assets, how these assets are. So I'm proposing to merge these categories into pavement, electronic furniture, and road furniture and structures, just in terms of geometry. And then I will check about if the defects are similar, so I can propose, make more subcategories of these main categories. I will not deal with the structures, because the road structures require a different kind of inspection, so that makes my life easier. So if we go to the pavement, for example, The pavement has two different categories. It has the asphalt pavement and the concrete pavement. And of course, we sorry, you have another third category, which is a composite, which has also both asphalt and is both asphalt and concrete layers. So what I'm suggesting is actually that since the defects of this pavement is actually mostly influenced by the material, either asphalt or concrete, we can actually divide this the pavement. We can have two subcategories, asphalt and concrete pavement, only this, without without the composite pavement. So in terms of the road furniture, we have the barriers, for example, the barriers like the guardrails that exist always on the side of the road or in the main or in the middle of the road. So they also have similar similar geometry because they have a particular height. And also they have, so we can actually merge the categories on fences and guardrails in the same one. The other category that we can use is the road markings. The road markings are both, both the road markings like the colored surface in the middle of the road, and also the road markings like the cut size and the bolts. So the difference between the cut size bolts and the road markings here is that the road markings have is a colored surface which is already which is always in the middle of the lane of the lane of the pavement, and also the cut size are always on the edge of the road lane. So, and they also have, and the bolts, they have different structure. They are they have mechanical structure, and they also have different kind of defects. In the regards with ITS elements, we have the loop detectors and the ram detectors that have actually, when the my inspector goes on the road, what he or she sees is only a traffic light, because this is how these loop detectors and ram detectors work. So when there are some issues with this kind of assets, the only thing that he might see is that the traffic light doesn't work, for example, or it has some issues. So going to the defects of these assets, we can see, for example, that the asphalt pavement has this type of defects, the usual, usual ones, like crack detect, like sorry, edge crack, alligator cracks, potholes, and so on. So Yorgos has done an excellent work on this, and I actually inspired my work from his. So they, he has actually done, he put into categories all the defects, and after that, according to the defect, they according to if the defect is of low or medium or high intensity, this defect has a different maintenance technique, according to the colors, as you can see here. Red color, that this defect goes to this kind of maintenance technique. So so I continue the work from there, and I did this only for the concrete pavement. For example, we have almost similar defects with the asphalt one, with the only difference in some ones only, just for example, in the box out defect here, which doesn't exist that much in the asphalt pavement. So again, I follow the same structure as Yorgos one. So again, I continue the work like putting into separate defects with different colors on separate maintenance techniques. And like, for example, the spalling, a medium intensity spalling goes to a full depth patching, for example. So I continue this with the road furnitures because it was very hard to find some of the defects of the road furnitures because they don't exist in the manuals or it's very hard to find them. I asked many people from Highways England and my company Bentley Systems to how we can, how if there are, for example, which are considered as the main defects of the road furniture. So for example, they, I found together, if I, you combine all this knowledge together, I found about the damage signs, the faded signs or missing signs, for example, or drainage, the defects of the drainage might be either flooded or blocked, or for example, for the markings can be faded or don't exist at all. So again, I continue this categorization. I put again the road furniture on the first row, then their defects on the second, and the maintenance techniques according to what I heard from what they told me from the Highways England and Bentley Systems on the third category. So the same thing for the electronic furniture, where we have, for example, either broken light bulbs there's message signs, the electronic message signs that might not work, for example, which is actually, this is the broad category of one of the broad defects that this electronic furniture might have, that they don't work. So again, the same thing. The first line is the electronic signs. Then the defects that one inspector of Highway Signal told me, you can just say they don't work properly. And then, of course, the maintenance technique, which is a technician should fix it. So this is the proposed solution. The pavement is, we categorize the pavement into just asphalt and concrete, the electronic furniture in lights, electronic signs, and traffic lights, and the road.